David says to Judah that they are of his bone and flesh. Then Israel and Judah argue, and the elders of Judah say that David is their close relative. And Israel says that they are more of David's kingdom. The fight will lead to another rebellion. They aren't seeing themselves as one body. They aren't recognizing they are of the same flesh and bone. Ephesians 5:30 from the New King James Version reads, "For we are members of his body, of his flesh and of his bones." The church is the body of Christ. The body of Christ is the church. We are one people, born of the same seed, all taking after the image of Jesus. We should all be moving as one body. Muscles should be helping bones move, and joints should provide the means. Platelets should be coming into the aid where there has been a cut. The eyes should be looking out and warning about what's up ahead, or sending good reports of the path made smooth before them. Denominations try to work as one with big meetings to try and keep everyone on the same page. They try to make corporate decisions. It's a poor imitation of the one body of Christ in action, though. Each denomination has their own meetings and their own decisions. They make rulings about what the Bible teaches and come to different conclusions. It leads to further division. I've only once been in a group that acted as one body. There were just four of us in a Bible study. There was one time when we all just knew what to do without talking. Another time while we were together, the Lord led me to do something which I obeyed, and then I asked the group, "Why did I just do that?" And one of the girls said it was for her. The Spirit knows and blows and where to flow, where it's going. The only way to move fluidly as the body of Christ is to move with the Spirit of God. There was a time I wondered why it wasn't like that at home with my kids and husband, and the Lord showed me how my husband and I did have one mind. We don't get into arguments. We have no long-standing disagreements over any big thing. We talk and pray, and it's settled. Whatever it is, it's put into the Lord's hands to direct our path. We give it to the Lord and follow the wind of the Spirit. He'll work it out and lead us in the way we should go.